وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, I want to speak about the purpose of why we are fasting. What is the reason why we're fasting? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, those of you who believe, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the people of iman are being spoken to here. نِدَاءٌ لِأَهْلِ الْإِيمَانِ Allah is addressing the people of iman. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ Fasting has been ordained upon you. It's been made obligatory upon you. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ Like it was made obligatory on those who came before you. And then Allah tells us the hikmah and the illah, the reason and the wisdom of why He legislated the fasting. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us, it is what? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ It is to attain taqwa. Taqwa is why we are fasting. Someone asks you, why are you fasting? You know it's because to attain taqwa. Some people, subhanAllah, today they'll say to you, if you ask them, why are you fasting? He will say, because fasting is a health or a fitness, or it's got health benefits. And so if you fast, you become healthy, you become this and that. And they forget the purpose in which Allah mentioned. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Fasting brings about taqwa. By fasting, you attain taqwa. The scholars, they mention that the purpose why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us is to worship Him. And the reason why Allah created us is to worship Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us why He wants us to worship Him. So yani, pay attention to this point. The reason you were created is to worship Allah. And the reason why you worship Allah is to attain taqwa. Then taqwa is a result of the purpose in which you're created from. Because you were created to worship Allah, and from your ibadah you attain taqwa. And fasting is an ibadah. It brings about taqwa. The question here is, my beloved brothers and sisters, what is taqwa? If you don't know something, can you really come with it? Can you come with taqwa if you don't know what taqwa means? I'm going to give you the best definition of taqwa. A definition that Shaykh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah was pleased with. And he said that this is the most comprehensive definition of a taqwa. And it's none other than the definition said by Talq ibn Habib. Talq ibn Habib, when he defined a taqwa, he said, أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله وأن تترك معصية الله على نور من الله تخاف عقاب الله. He said, التقوى means أن تعمل بطاعة الله. It is to act in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني your action, you're doing it in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that's what you are, you're a slave. You need to obey your master. And the master is who? Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you are acting in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala nuri min Allahi. But the act of obedience, it's based on a light from Allah. Ya'ani, it's based upon a revelation. It's based upon a revelation. the way that you are acting and the way that you are doing things is all based upon a legislation set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not doing it based on your own whims and desires and the thoughts that come to your mind. You're doing it based on evidences that you've gathered from the Qur'an and the Sunnah. عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ تَرْجُو ثَوَابَ اللَّهِ. And whilst you're doing it, you're hoping reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to, He's going to reward you for what you're doing. Because there's no one else who can reward you other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reward is in His hands. He's the one who can give you the reward. وَأَن تَتْرُكَ مَعْصِيَةَ اللَّهِ. And it is also to leave off the sins. To abstain and stay far from it. عَلَى نُورِ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Based on a light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made impermissible and haram, you do it. You do what? You stay away from it. You abstain from it. You don't indulge in doing it. تَخَافُ عِقَابَ اللَّهِ. You are fearful of the punishment of Allah. That is taqwa. And my beloved brothers and sisters, it is the people of taqwa that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us that they're going to inherit Jannah. That's why Allah said in the ayah, تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِثُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَ تَقِيًّا. Jannah will be inherited by the pious people of taqwa are going to inherit Jannah. Allah even told us subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Qur'an that it's the people of taqwa who are going to be saved from the hellfire. And they're the ones who are not going to fall into the hellfire when other people will be falling into it. وَإِن مِّنكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَّقَضِيًّا ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَنَظَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِثِيًّا. Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala that everybody else is going to fall into the hellfire. The only people Allah is going to save are who? ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. The people we're going to save are the pious people. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that the taqwa gushes from and it springs from the heart. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "At-taqwa ha huna, at-taqwa ha huna, at-taqwa ha huna." The Prophet said, "The taqwa is here, the taqwa is here, the taqwa is here," 3 times, alayhi salatu wasalam. We need to familiarize ourselves with the definition of taqwa. Because if you're ignorant of the definition of something, you're not going to come with it. Ali ibn Abi Talib gave another definition to taqwa, which is worth mentioning. Ali ibn Abi Talib, and he said, taqwa is al-khawfu min al-jalil. It is to be scared of Allah. Wal-amalu bit-tanzil. It is to work in accordance to the revelation. Wal-rida bil-qaleel. And it is to be pleased with the little Allah has given you. Contentment. وَاسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. And it's to prepare for the day of judgment. 4 things he mentioned. الْخَوْفُ مِنَ الْجَلِيلِ. It is to be scared of Allah. وَالْعَمَلُ بِالْتَنْزِيلِ. It is to act upon the Qur'an and the Sunnah. وَالْرِضَى بِالْقَلِيلِ. And to be content with whatever Allah has given you. وَاسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. And it's to prepare for the day of departure. The day when you're going to leave this world and you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those 4 things, Ali ibn Abi Talib, and he said that is what taqwa is. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz said a very powerful statement, which I'm going to conclude with inshaAllah ta'ala. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, and he said, لَيْسَ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ بِصِيَامِ النَّهَارِ وَلَا بِقِيَامِ اللَّيْلِ. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, and he said, taqwa is not fasting daytime and praying at night. وَالتَّقْلِيطِ فِي مَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. And it's not to mix the two. No, that's not, none of that. وَلَكِنْ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ تَرْكُ مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ وَأَدَاءُ مَا افْتَرَضَ اللَّهِ فَمَنْ رُزِقَ. He said, فَمَنْ رُزِقَ ذَلِكَ خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ إِلَى خَيْرٍ. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahimahullah, he said that taqwa is not to fast the daytime and to pray at night time. And it's not to emerge the two. Rather, what taqwa is that you leave off that which Allah prohibited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do what was obliged upon you, and made mandatory upon you. He then said, فَمَنْ رُزِقَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ. Anyone who this has been given to them, then verily he has been given good with good. Look how the Salaf, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz and Talq ibn Habib and other great a'imma, look how they looked at taqwa. For them, taqwa summarized the concept of Islam. For them, taqwa was what? Do as you are told and stay away from what you are told to stay away from. That's it. As a slave, that's all it is for you. You do what you're told to do and you stay away from what you were told to stay away from. And you'll find the doors of success and prosperity and happiness and joy will come your way in this world. And the day of judgment, nothing else awaits you except Jannah. That is all that is needed from us. This month of Ramadan coming, we have to fulfill the wisdom and the hikmah for fasting. يعني when you look at the Qur'an, Allah mentioned, يَا الَّذِينَ عَمَلُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. He said in the ayah 183. If you go to ayah 187, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also concluded it by saying, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Both verses, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala concluded it with لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The first verse of the fasting, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And the last one, Allah concluded it with لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Why? You ponder here and you contemplate. You stand over it. Because the hikmah and the illah for fasting is to attain taqwa. Why are you fasting if you're not going to attain taqwa from it? Why would you stay away from food and drinking if you're not going to gain taqwa from it? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who attain taqwa from their fasting. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.